We get asked a lot of questions on the utility disconnect process. It can be a little confusing at times, but it's absolutely necessary before demolition can take place to get all the utilities cut, capped, and disconnected. The first thing you gotta figure out is who's gonna do it. Is it the property owner, the homeowner, the general contractor, your demolition contractor? Any of those parties can perform it. If the property owner wants to subcontract this portion of the job, they still have to get involved a little bit in providing proof of ownership and potentially limited power of attorney to either the GC or the demolition contractor. If you want to start your project in 2 to 3 weeks, you need to start the utility disconnect process today. The first item you need to get started is the disconnection of the gas lines. It takes the longest, and that is your first step. How do you figure out who your utility providers are? We found the easiest way to do this is just call or go online and get an e-ticket for 811. It gives you a nice clean list of all the utility providers for the property, and you can start dialing for dollars and getting in touch with these guys and letting them know that you've got a pending demolition project and you need to get the utilities disconnected. The first and most important item is the gas. Everyone's seen news stories of explosions and contractors hitting gas lines and evacuating whole city blocks. You don't want this to be you. So you need to make sure this is the most important thing to tell the gas company. You want it cut and capped at the street. You want them to go to the street, cut the gas line physically and cap it at the street, so the line coming into your property is dead all the way to your property and there's no chance of disturbing that line. Second most important is electrical. If the power's overhead, you tell the power company you want it dropped from the pole. If it's underground, then you want it cut in the clear and gapped. You want a physical gap between the transformer and the lines that are coming to your building. When we do it, we meet the power company on site and ensure that it's done. The gas is pretty easy to verify. If it looks like somebody's dug a hole in the ground next to where the yellow gas marker is from 811, you can be pretty sure that they did that. The water, pretty easy. You call the municipality if you want them to cap it, or most contractors have a water key. You can just turn it off at the street. All depends on how you're gonna reuse the existing lines. Sewer is the only item that has a third-party cost outside of just the time it takes to make the phone calls. Typically, you've got to get a licensed contractor with an underground license to dig down to where the sewer is going to be cut and cap that sewer line. There's a few other items that we often see overlooked. The telecom providers are listed on your 811. It'll be AT&T, Comcast, fiber providers. They may have equipment attached to your building. If they do, the building owner may have that leased, and these utility providers may want to get it. If you don't notify them, they're going to send you a bill for whatever you trashed that was there. So get something in writing from them saying that they're abandoning that equipment, or make sure that they come pick it up. The other thing that we're seeing is with high-speed internet, T1 lines, all these things being upgraded everywhere, that infrastructure is super expensive to repair. If you end up excavating anywhere around fiber lines, it's critically important that that you do maybe even go beyond a public locate and do a private locate. It's good money spent to make sure that you're not breaking one of those fiber lines that cost, you know, many thousands of dollars to repair. The main reason these disconnects are done is safety. You've got to safe up the structure before you demo it. So that should be most of what you need to know to get your utilities off to your building.